Hi, and thanks for being here. My name is Claire Genoux, and I'm data analyst at PeopleDoc by Ultimate Software for more than a year. If you never heard about PeopleDoc, I'm pretty sure at least one day you've been in one of the following situations. So either you've never had an answer to an email sent to your HR, or maybe you've been watching in front of your mailbox for several days waiting for your employment contract. Or again, you did not know what would happen on your first day of work. This is why PeopleDoc has been founded in 2007 to help you deal with this type of issue in putting in place a HR solution that is secure, intuitive, fast, and more recently, data-oriented. PeopleDoc has been acquired by Ultimate Software in 2018 and is proud to be today labeled French Tech, with more than 300 employees to meet the needs of more than 2,000 customers split on a single platform of 4 products that covers the whole employee life cycle from the hiring process to the departure of the company. So with more than 70% of HR considering people analytics with one of their biggest priority within an organization, last year, we decided to rethink our analytical solution. For this reason, we are proud today to speak about the embedded analytics that we realized in our platform and which contrasts a lot with the standalone application that was previously proposed. So why did we decide to change for another solution? First of all, I would like to specify that as a standalone application, our database wasn't connected directly to the application. So in order to have dashboard, our data was created and sent using SQL script that was exported with a daily refresh. Using this methodology had been leading to several issues. And one was the data modeling was complex as we needed to handle each client characteristic. With a daily refresh, the clients were not happy with the accuracy as he was looking for live data. In the same time, sometimes the application didn't work and we were not informed about it. So the reliability became uncertain. And finally, the tool was complex to handle for HR users. It was time consuming for us as we needed to spend time to help them to use the tool instead of unlocking value for the company. This is why we looked at other solutions, and after investigation, we decided to join Looker. So why? First, it's because of the security that was meeting all our clients' needs with the on-premise, the ISO 27001 certification, and the O2. We could finally use a flexible tool thanks to the LookML, so the data modeling was easy to build. It was also easy for users to use the tool with the drag and drop to create visualization, and Looker being compatible with PostgreSQL and plus the on-premise, we were able to offer to our clients a live dashboard experience. So during the implementation, we've made some discoveries and we wanted to share them with you. The first one being, of course, the documentation. Efforts have been made from day one to write it, which represent to them more than 70 pages of technical writing, definition of metrics, FAQ, learning. And as an example, when we were creating LookML dashboard, we delivered simultaneously the LookML dashboard and the documentation. This methodology, easy to reproduce, helped us a lot. On two sides. The first one, as analysts, we did not need to deconstruct each visualization a few months later, only to write the documentation. And for a reviewer, he exactly knew what, which metrics was used to build the dashboard. Once all the documentation work has been done, each dashboard had been documented, which represents 7 dashboards, with a lot of clients having particularities. We needed to create dashboards that that fits for everyone. So in order to follow this, we applied the Schneiderman visualization mantra, which consists to follow one rule, an overview, the ability to zoom and filter, and the on-demand details. Each dashboard was reviewed and validated by a product owner, and clients' feedback were centralized by another team. So said like that, it can sound easy peasy, while in reality, dashboards were modified between 2 or 3 times before the final validation. Once all the dashboards have been created, we've met another challenge, was the internationalization of our dashboard. PeopleDoc having HR users all over the world, we needed to be able to deliver this dashboard in 26 languages. Of course, it was unthinkable to create as many dashboards as we have languages. It should mean 182 dashboards to create, to breed, not to mention to implement, so it was a no-no. For this reason, we've looked at a third-party service named Crodin to automate all the translation. If you are not yet familiar with Looker, the next slide are a bit more technical. So Looker allows the creation of labels in each field in the LookML views and LookML dashboard. Looker being connected to GitHub, we are also able to connect Crodin, the third-party service, to the same repository of GitHub. So once we created a label for each field, we centralized all this label in one file still in Looker, adding a context for each label, a context being a definition, and we push this file into GitHub. This file sent to GitHub was cached by Crodin, and we were able automatically to translate to have a translator to do it. And automatically, once it was translated, Crodin sent automatically this file into the same repository in GitHub. We only need to review, and once it was approved, just need to pull the modification into Looker in order to obtain our dashboard internationalized. During the embedding, using Looker, we have been able to realize this, taking into account each product's characteristics and respecting the deadline. So the use of Looker for us allowed us to increase the value of your work in relation to the time devoted to do it. It was incredibly fast to build, fast to implement, and fast to maintain. Within an organization where specialized teams are receiving more and more requests from all the other departments, we were approximately 20 involved in this project and split into the product and development team. The kickoff started in Q3 last year with the documentation, the settings, the data modeling, and the dashboarding. Once the implementation with the API and all the security tests has been done, we've been able to launch the embedded analytics beginning of Q2 this year. Today, the rollout of the embedding analytics is fully completed, and we already started to delivering the advanced analytics, which is a premium version. From now on, also, we received less lots of questions from our user on how to use the tool, how the metrics are calculated. Instead, users now spend time to analyze and take actions instead of unscrabble the tool. And in the same time, earlier this year, I went to a data HR meetup in which one of their conclusions was the standardization of predictive analytics. This is why we will look to do predictive analytics in Looker and embed this for the next year. Using our former tool, we were not able to make profit. It is now the case. We are able to differentiate a standard offer which is embedded into the products from the advanced analytics, and for which the BI team will intervene as consultant to create tailored analysis. HR user, we also have the possibility to buy KPI available in a catalog. And by far the most important, the client engagement, feedbacks on the embedded analytics and the quality of the visualization had a unanimous success. And not only, being able to create and embed analytics separate from the product release planning allow us to make quick improvements, and this specificity didn't escape to our users. And as it will be a shame to stop after such good start, next year we will continue with the continuous improvement, looking at the monthly product release of Looker, but also with the system activity to analyze the use of your users in order to be proactive to improve our dashboards. In the same time, we will also look to change our internal BI for Looker. We will do, as mentioned earlier, predictive analysis. And finally, we will change the Looker embedding for the API instead of the iframe, as it was currently the case.